All right, this is a quick workout that you can do. If you don't have time for a full workout, but you want to hit every muscle and stretch afterwards, this is your workout. Stay tuned with me. But before we get started, make sure to subscribe to my channel and then like and comment afterwards. All right, let's go. Let's begin our warm-up with some arm swings. Just make sure you've got some room. You don't hit anything. Go back and forth. Alternate your arm on top and then turn it into some arm circles. This wakes up our shoulders, our chest. Now take it the opposite direction. All right, meet me at goalpost. Our arms here, touch the elbows, and then overhead. Good, starting to feel those shoulders get a little warmer. All right, now let's do some hip openers. I want to do just some rolls first. Have your hands on your hip. Pretend you're hula hooping, whatever you need. Go one direction a few times and then go the other way. So at some points in our workout, you might need something to hold on to, whether that's a wall or maybe a chair nearby. This might be one of them. We're going into leg swings. You soften your left leg. You start swinging your right. So if I feel like I might lose my balance here, I can find a wall. The point is to get this hamstring warmed up and the hip. Doesn't matter if you're holding on to something or not. Good, and get that hamstring a little bit warmer. Let's do some soccer kicks. We put down that foot. We're gonna take the right leg and kick across. So stand nice and tall, arms out. Start with a little kick. And I want you to think about leading with the heel. So this is excellent stability as well because you have to balance on that foot for a moment. If you're feeling comfortable, legs warming up a little bit, do a higher kick. Just don't drop your chest to get higher, so don't do this. No need. All right, let's do the leg swing with the other side. So now we're standing on our right leg. Soften that bottom leg. We start swinging. Using that wall if we need to, or chair. Chair would work too. And once that hip feels pretty good, we turn it into our soccer kicks. So we're gonna kick across. Small kick, chest up, abs tight. And then maybe you can kick a little higher. And I'm definitely feeling my hamstring waking up, my hip. But now I need to make sure your back is warm. So let's come out of our soccer kick, shake it out a little bit. And we're going to soften the knees, tuck your chin into your chest, and you can grab or just touch, but you're gonna bubble your back. Feel my shoulders separating. Then I open up the chest and pull the tailbone out. So I'm going back and forth, and from the side, you'll see that my back flattens out, arches a little bit. And this feels really good on the low back, but it works the upper back too. Very good, and then back upright. All right, time to get these legs a little warmer with your toes straight ahead. I'm gonna start little and then reach tall. I squat and I lift. Good, now when you get to the top next time, hold it there, then drop your right arm. Reach taller with the left. If you keep your core tight, you're protecting your low back. So bring that arm back up. And you sweep down, up, drop the left arm. Now, if you're taking care of your back, even though your abs are tight, you might want a modification, so it's here. Good job, one more time each side. If you're okay with your balance, bring your feet closer together. All right, let's get a little warmer. We're gonna start squat and then go to toes. So start little. Then we're gonna get a little bit more powerful. Down and up. Very good. All right, and just to test those that balance, let's stop going to toes. And when you come up, twist to the right. Come back down. When you come up, twist left. Now, keep your chest lifted and your back flat on this one. One more time each side, please. All right. Let's sweep the arms all the way up. Soften your knees just a little bit. Arms shoot out, hinge at the hip. So I can keep a flat back and stop right here if I'm not comfortable going upside down. But if I don't mind going upside down, hold on somewhere, no dangling of the hands. And release the head, shake it side to side. Feeling a good stretch down my hamstrings. Now soften your knees and lift your chest. So modified is up here. If I want a deeper stretch, I'm down here. But before you go any more, my knees are bent, my back is flat. Now try to straighten out your legs. Very good. Back to bending the knees, roll it on up, reach tall. Let's do that sequence again. We're gonna swan dive. Forward fold, hold on somewhere. Lift a monkey. Take a deep breath here. Back to forward fold. Bend the knees and roll it on up. Good. All right, we're going down to the mat, so we're gonna swan dive all the way down. Now bend your knees if you need to get down there, but palms are flat. And then we come down to all fours. Then we're gonna sit back in child. So this is our resting pose. Anytime you need a break, you can always do child's pose. If you walk those fingertips out a little further, you'll get a nice stretch through the shoulders. I feel it in my low back. You might even feel your quads. All right, from here we go to our first down dog. So I want you to spread out your fingertips. Flip under your toes, come off the knees, and pull your tailbone high. Now, it is okay if you bend your knees, as long as you keep your back flat. Bring your feet a little closer together and start pedaling your feet. I will show you from the side. I'm waking up my calves, my ankles, and my hamstrings, and the shoulders are strengthening. And then return back to child's when you're done. All right, time to wake up hip flexors. Let's bring that right leg in front first. Take your time getting there. Now you might need extra padding back there. Gardening mats are wonderful for that. You don't need anything fancy. Chest up, gently pivot your hips forwards. I'm feeling it right here. And I can circle my arm while I'm here. Reach tall. Good job. That hand's gonna come down, work the other leg out. Or work that leg out. Let's go to the left leg in front now. Take your time. One side is a little bit more flexible than the other, so take your time. All right, remember I'm hanging here. If it just kills my knee to be here, I can come up and do this stretch. Pivot the hips forwards, exact same stretch, just not as deep. You're also not on the knee. But my front knee should not go past my toes. And then I'm gonna circle the arm. Getting everything nice and warm. Very good. Now from here, I'm gonna go back to child's pose. Take that leg out carefully. And then when you're ready, we're gonna stand it upright and get a sip of water. Warm up is complete. All right, the body's warm, it's time to work. We're gonna start with our right foot in front. We're gonna plant the left heel down. From there, you're gonna take your left hip and gently pull it forwards. Now, it might not be warmed up quite yet, so you're gonna start to flow. So remember, I'm gonna start you in basic poses, and you're welcome to stay there. But then we're gonna progress. And you can join me if you like. So maybe I'm gonna flow one arm, or both. Now, once you're feeling warm enough here, I want you to hold. Concentrate on a few things. Is my back heel flat? Don't let it come up. I'm gonna sink a little deeper in that front leg, and then focus on the shoulders. Sometimes I see this. I want shoulders back and down, lengthen the neck. Give me two more deep breaths here. So I am feeling my left hip flexor stretching, hips working, and the right thighs talking, and the shoulders. All right, let's take this left arm down. We're going to warrior two. So we sweep that arm back. Now I turn my body towards the left wall. My feet are still in a straight line. And I extend shoulders back and down. I'm gonna show you from the side. Right here, notice my knee does not jut past my toe. If I need a break, I flow. Otherwise, hold it here. Now I'm waking up my inner thigh on that right side. Come back and join you. Okay, give me two more deep breaths. Tuck in your back hip. All right, extended angle, drop the front arm. Reach that left arm up and over. Now before you go, pull the shoulder blade back. There's an imaginary wall behind you. Then reach the arm. Palm face out on the front. That way I can't hold on. And I breathe. Keep holding, showing you from the side. Front thigh is talking now. Trying to make a straight line from your fingertips down to your toes. And then ease on out. Good, walk in that back foot a little bit. Now, we're coming to crescent lunge. So you're gonna turn your hips forwards. Now, you can stay in a warrior one if you feel more comfortable, but try to pick up the back heel. Do you need a chair next to you just in case, or a wall? Chest up, lower your hips. Now the front leg is bending, this back leg is trying to straighten. I can hold on here on my thigh, I can be at heart center. One arm up because I'm using a chair, or both arms up. All right, now we're gonna work strength a little bit. I am working strength. We're gonna work more strength. So if you need something to hold on to, great option to have. First one's a little dicey, I'm in a wide spot. So hands on hip, narrow your stance just a little. We're doing step-ins. We step in, but we stay low. And then I take that foot back. And notice it's my toe. If I need more stability, I can go here. But I'm gonna step in, and I'm gonna step back. Now the minute you straighten this front leg, you're taking a break. So try not to. In and out. Hands wherever you want them. These are our step-ins. Keep those arms up. You can bring them down in front. Lots of options. All right, your front thigh should be burning. This right one is mad. You might want more sensation. If that's you, this next one's called runners, okay? Put all the weight in this front leg and not your toes, your heel. You ready? Here's a runner. In, out. In, out. I never straighten this front leg and it burns back here. Now, more sensation, if you want it, run it. In and out, stay low. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Ooh, plant that back foot. It should be mad. You should be feeling that. All right, we're going to the floor. Take your time. You might want to step in your back foot. But you do want your palms flat. No fingertips. And take that foot out. All right, if you need a break, you can be in down dog otherwise. I'm sorry, if you need a break, you can be in child's pose. Otherwise, you're here with me. All right, we're working a little lower body. So we're gonna hinge forwards to a full plank. Modification, knees. I'm gonna go down dog to full plank. And I've got options. I can stay right here. Or if anyone wants more sensation, when you lower to that full plank, pick up one foot just an inch. Back to down dog. It's a little easier if your feet are together. Then you've got more stability when you pick up that foot. And just alternate feet. So remember, I've shown you lots of options. Listen to your body on this one. One more time each side. Working upper body, lower body, and tons of core. All right, back to a down dog. Let's finish strong. We go to full or soft plank. You might need your knees on this one. We're gonna lower down very slow. Shaving the elbows to the sides of the body. Once you make it to the bottom, Come up to those forearms and open up your chest. Now I see a lot of shrugging on this one. Pull them back and down. And then from here, abs tight. Take it back to child's pose. This is a wonderful time for you to grab a sip of water and take a break. We got one more side to go. Remember, it's quick, but it's ruthless. All right, we did the right leg last time. Now it's the left leg's turn. Let's put that left foot in front. I'm gonna plant that right heel down. Remember, the heel does not come up. Then we take this right hip and gently pull it forwards. It's gonna talk to you right here. All right, you can hold onto your thigh. You can be at heart center. We're gonna sink and then straighten. Your chest is upright. If you're ready for one arm, you can do one arm or both. And then remember, once you get warm here, I want you to hold. So maybe the next time you do this workout, you don't have to flow as much. You can get right into it. But you gotta listen to your body. It'll let you know. How's your shoulders? No hunching. You'll just be tighter tomorrow. Now try to get the weight into the left heel, okay? It wants to go to the toes. Bring it more to the heel. All right, let's drop this right arm. Meet me in warrior two. Shoulders back and down. This front knee is trying to pull to the right. Open it up. Now remember, you have the option to flow. You can see me in the mirror. But if you're ready for more sensation, hold. Good, pull that knee open. Shoulders back and down. Take some deep breaths. Great work on the lower body here. Isometric hold with the arms. All right, extended angles next. Drop that front arm. We don't put any body weight here, just gentle touch. We do pick up this right arm. Pull the shoulder blade back first. This hand can be palm out so you cannot hold on. And then you begin to reach as you sink deeper. Good, I could get a lot lower if I stick my bottom out, but I'm not going there. Three. And two. And then ease on out. Ooh, I felt that front leg talking. We're about to make it talk more. We're moving into crescent lunge. You can hold on for more support. We pick up this back heel. Remember, if you need more stability, you could have your feet a little wider, or you could plant this foot. Let's settle in with me. Chest up, lower the hips. I can hold on. If I don't need my hands, pick them up. Very good. All right, it's time for some serious strength. You could skip this part. You could just hold. You could flow. But if you want more, hands down for support on the first one. Step the back foot in. Maybe you wiggle it in a little first, then step in. Stay low, step back. Now, the lower you get, the more it's gonna talk. If you don't need your hands, you can keep them in. You can flow them up, whatever works. Good, these are our step-ins. You may stay with these. But if you're ready for more, we're gonna do the runners. Are you ready? Take the foot back, sink into this front leg, weight's in the heel, here we go. Reach and run, run and back. Lower you get, more it's gonna talk. Anybody wanna speed it up? Ooh, that leg's talking. Heart rate's rising. Three, two, one. Plant it, shake it on out. Good job. And then take it on down. Good, we're going to the mat. Take your time getting down there. Remember, palms stay flat. And we go to down dog. All right, I like my feet a little closer together when I do my plank work. But you can still drop your heels and pull your tailbone high. If you need a break, it's child's pose. All right, hinge forwards. If I need to modify, set my knees down. If I don't, keep them up. Down dog to full plank. Shoulders should be right on top of wrists. Never sag in your shoulders. Pull them back and down. All right, this next one's tough. It's a hip opener. Center your left foot underneath you and pick up your right. I can stay right here if I want, but I want you to try to close down the hips. So this seems easier. Close it down. Push away from the mat. Drop that left heel down. All right, to turn it into a hip opener, bend your top leg. Take your right hip towards the sky. I'm gonna open up. Now listen to your body on this one. I don't want you to flop over. You're trying to pull that knee skyward. Should feel pretty good here. All right, let's untangle. And then rest in child's. Just a moment, giving that core a break. An upper body. But we got one more time lifting a leg, so when you're ready, spread fingertips wide, flip under those toes, pull your tailbone to the sky. All right, I like to center my foot underneath me. We're picking up the left leg this time. But keep your hips closed down. Drop that right heel. Push away from the mat. I'm extended through the arms. All right, I'm going to bend my top leg and then open the hip. So now I take that left hip skyward. And your body will tell you when to stop. Still trying to sink down your right heel. Give me two more deep breaths. Ooh, your arm should be shaking now. Untangle, full plank. And then lower to the mat. Beautiful. Let's come on down and stretch it out again. Shoulders back and down. Give a good stretch. And then back to child's. Another water break. It's time for cool down. Did awesome. We're moving into cool down. If you have any kind of strap, something that doesn't stretch, grab that now. Hand towel might work great too. You set it aside, we'll get to it. We're gonna start off with pigeon pose. Anytime I do kind of a crazy floor stretch, I always show a modification. So here's our modification. When you're lying down, you're gonna cross one leg over the top. You're gonna flex your foot. That keeps your knee safe. And then you're gonna gently pull your knee towards the front of the room. So this might be where you stop, or if you want more sensation, pick up the bottom foot, take your hand through the legs, gentle pull. Or, you know, if you need a lot more help, use the strap, okay? If you're pretty flexible, maybe you can grab here, just don't round your back to get there. So that's our modification. We'll do both sides. All right, if you'd like to try pigeon pose with me, then turn to the front so you can see me better. I would like everyone to start on all fours. We're going to pick up the knees just a little bit so that we can take our right knee to the right corner of the room, outside of your wrist. Notice it's not pointing straight ahead. That's the hip opener part. All right, so I set down my back knee, that left knee, and I wiggle my left foot back. Now your goal is to try to get these hips flush to the ground. They might not get there. It's a journey. If it hurts your knee, that's your sign that you need to modify and do the lying one. All right, so once you're here, even if your hips aren't all the way down, you can stay right here. Just take some deep breaths. You can go a little lower to forearms. You could stack two fists to your forehead, or you could take your arms all the way out and try to lay down lying flush. So you've got different options there, but I want you to find one and just take some deep breaths. I'm gonna get back to my spot. If you suffer from sciatica, this is a great stretch for that. Now you can stay here as long as you want. If you can reach, pause, just hang out here and breathe. But if you are ready to come out, come upright to your hands first. Flip under your back toe. Use that upper body strength we just worked on to pull that leg out and pedal. So I'm stretching out my calves now. And then if I pull my tailbone high and drop the heels for my down dog, I'm stretching out my hamstrings too. All right, we did the right leg last time. It's time for the left knee. So we're going to take our, we're going to take our left knee to the corner of the room, set down that back knee, and gently wiggle. Now, you might be able to do one side, but then not the other. That's okay. Modify. Lie on your back. It's all the same stretch. You can go a little lower. Two fists to the forehead. Or full extension. But if you hold your breath, you are trying to fight this pose. You need to breathe through it. These are the poses that make your body feel better. All right, if you are all the way down, give me one more deep breath and then work your way back up to your hands so you can meet with me. Flip under that back toe. We're gonna use that upper body strength to pull ourselves out and then we'll pedal again. And after you've pedaled a few times, let's come back to child's pose. All right, we're gonna focus on our hamstrings next. So find that strap I asked you to grab. Flip over onto your back. We're gonna take it on down. We're gonna hook our right leg first. You stretch out your left leg. And now I'm just grabbing onto this strap and giving it a gentle pull. My shoulder blades roll back and down. I take some deep breaths here. I'm trying to drive my shoulder blades back and down. And rather than do a big bicep curl, just walk your hands up higher. One more deep breath here. And then soften that knee, untangle. All right, let's do the other leg. Hook our left foot. One hamstring's gonna be tighter than the other. That's normal. Breathe through it. Trying to take that leg just another half inch, but we never overstretch. Don't wanna pull a muscle. All right, we're gonna finish with dead bug pose. It's got a silly name, but it feels good. Set your strap down, pick up both feet. Now, we're gonna put our feet on the ceiling. Okay, do not let your feet aim backwards. They're always straight up. Now, open up your legs and then bend your knees. So it's not a straddle split because your knees are bent. Now, modification, I'm gonna grab right here and hang out. If I can take a little bit more, I'm gonna reach for the tops of my shoes, even if I have to pick up my bottom to get there. Now try to pull your tailbone down. Open up your legs and bend your knees. This is a groin stretch. And you look silly doing it, but it makes your body feel good. Good, now if you can keep that low tailbone down and you wanna rock left to right just a little bit, you can do that, just an option. All right, release the feet, bring the knees into the chest, and hug. We're trying to pull our tailbone down, drive those shoulder blades back and down. This is a great stretch for your back, specifically your low back. But it's also great for the hips. All right, we're gonna release the feet. We're gonna take the arms up overhead. And we're gonna extend, point your toes, squeeze your bottom, tighten your thighs, abs, glutes, and shoulders. And then release. Grab a knee, help yourself up. And that's our quick workout today. I hope your body feels better. Try it again. If you continue to do this workout, you'll be able to do those added sensations, get more out of it. Thanks for joining me.